Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, let's see how we can print this number pattern. So to print this number pattern, we need to consider three steps. Okay, what are the three steps to get this number pattern? Let's see. Okay, step one, we need to consider to print this pattern, we need to consider three loops. One loop for rows, another loop for zeros before number, another loop for printing zeros after number. Okay, so we need to consider these three steps in order to print the pattern. See, now let's go on with the first step, loop for rows. We need to consider a for loop for printing the number of rows. How many number of rows are there in this number pattern? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I need to initialize a variable that is int rows equals 5. Now I need to consider a loop for printing these numbers, these 5 rows. For that I need to use for int I equals 1 starting from 1, I lesser than or equals to rows, means 5 rows I want to print starting from 1. So 5 rows, okay, I equals 1, I lesser than or equals to rows, I plus plus. Okay, so this is the first step where I am printing loop for the rows. Next, loop for zeros before number. See, here we have numbers in the form of diagonal pattern. If you observe here, see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it's in diagonal pattern. So we are dividing these zeros, that is for third step, and these zeros, that is for second step. So second step, I want to print zeros before this number, right? So before this number, we need to consider one more loop. For that, I need to consider one more loop, that is inner loop, for int j equals 1, j less than I, j plus plus. So for this loop, I need to print zeros, right? So I need to use system.out.print of 0, because I want to print 0 with some space. Okay. Now if you observe here, this is the inner loop for int j equals 1, j less than I. Suppose I value is 1 in the first iteration. So j less than 1, that is 1 less than 1 condition is false. So 0 will not be printed in the first iteration, because I want to print this row first case. In the first iteration, I want to print this row. In this row, what I need? I need number first. I don't need zeros. That is before number, I don't need 0. So after this loop is executed, since this loop will not be executed successfully, why? Because the condition is getting false here. If you observe here, see, let me show you first iteration what will happen. In the first iteration, for that is int I equals 1, I lesser than equals to rows, what is the value of rows? 5. I lesser than equals to 5, I plus plus. Yes, this for loop, this condition is true. So what will happen? It will go inside this loop. Inside this loop, we have one more loop, that is int j equals 1, j less than I. What is the value of j? J is 1. 1 less than I. What is the value of I? I value is 1. 1 less than 1, that is j plus plus. Okay. So 1 is less than 1? No. The condition is false, right? 1 is not less than 1. So what will happen? It will come out of this loop. That is, this loop will not be executed. When it comes out of this loop, what I need to do? I need to print the number. So to print the number, what I need to do? I need to print the value from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the form of diagonal pattern. That is increasing order, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. To print this value, I need to use the value of I, because each time I is getting incremented, I plus plus, starting from 1 to 5. Rows value is 5, right? So 1 to 5, I will get the value, that is I. So what I need to do, if this condition is not satisfied, I need to write system.out.print of I value, because I want the number value to get printed. That's the reason I am using this statement. If this condition is not satisfied, then I want to print the value of the number, that is starting from 1 to 5. Okay, so now the one value got printed here after this statement. Next, what I need to do? I need to print these zeros. to print these zeros, I need to consider the next step, that is third step. I need to use one more loop, that is for int k equals I, k equals I, k less than rows, k plus plus. Okay, I need to consider this loop. If this loop gets satisfied, I need to print zeros, because I want to print the zeros after the number, right? That's the reason. So system.out.printf, I want to print zeros. I want to print the zeros. So what will happen? See, system.out.printf I, that is one I got printed in the first row. I need zeros to be printed. For that, we need to use this loop. So what will happen in this loop? K equals I. What is the value of I here? Value of I is 1. So k equals 1. 1 less than rows. What is the value of rows? Rows is 5. 1 less than 5. Yes, condition is true. So 0 will get printed. Next, again k plus plus. So k will be 2. 2 less than 5. Yes, condition is true. Again 1 more 0 will be printed. Then 3 less than 5. 1 more 0. 4 less than 5. Last 0. Then 5 less than 5, no, the condition is false. So we have completely executed the first row. We got first row now. So next, what I need to do? I need to go to the next row. To go to the next row, what I need to do? I need to write a statement, system.out.println. I need to use this statement to go to the next line. So this is how it works. The first loop is used for rows. The second loop, that is J loop, this loop is used for printing zeros before the number. Before the number, it is used for printing zeros. Then I am printing the value of I to print these numbers, followed by zeros again. Zeros I want to print after the number. So I am using one more loop. Three loops totally I need to use for this. Okay. In the second iteration, what will happen? After once this completely gets executed and the conditions will become false, I value will be incremented. I value will become 2. That is outermost loop. These are the inner loops. J loop and K loop are inner loops. I loop is the outer loop. I will get incremented. That is I plus plus. So I will become 2. So in second iteration, what will happen? Let's see. Iteration 2. In iteration 2, I value will become 2. Okay. I value has become 2. Now what will happen in this loop? For int I equals 1, I lesser than or equals to rows. I lesser than or equals to rows, that is 2 lesser than or equals to rows, I plus plus. Okay. Yes, 2 is lesser than or equals to 5. The condition is true. So it will come into the inside loop. So inside loop, what will happen? For int j equals 1, j less than I. See, j value is what? 1. What is the value of I now? I value in this case is, see, int I equals 2 now. It's not 1. It's 2, right? Because it's incremented here. So it is 2. 2 less than, 1 lesser than or equal to 2. Yes, condition is true. So what will happen? 0 will get printed. 0 will get printed in this case. Because I am going to print here system.out.printf. I am going to print 0. If this condition is satisfied, 0 will get printed, or else number will get printed. This loop is used for printing zeros before the number. Okay, this is how in iteration 2 it will work, and this will go on. For printing numbers, I am going to use I. For printing zeros before number, I am going to use J loop, and for printing zeros after the number, I am going to use K loop. This is the logic behind the number pattern. Now let's quickly jump to Eclipse and let's execute this program and check the output. Okay, let's switch to Eclipse. We already have created Java project patterns. Inside src folder we have number patterns package. So inside this package, let me create a new class, that is number pattern 7, okay, with public static void main. Okay, now inside this, first I need to declare variable int rows equals 5 because I want to print 5 rows. Then I need to use a loop int I equals 1, I lesser than or equals to rows I plus plus. Okay. This is the outer loop. So inside inner loop, I need to use one more loop, that is int j equals 1, j less than I, j plus plus. If this condition is satisfied, I need to print zeros, that is system dot out dot print of 0, because I want to print 0 before number. Okay, in this pattern, if you observe, I want to print zeros before number. For that, I am using this loop. If this condition is not satisfied, then I want to print the value, that is the number value in the diagonal pattern. For this, I need to use system.out.print of value of I need to use to get the number value. Now I need to consider one more loop for printing the zeros after the number. To printing zeros after the number, I need to use int k equals I, k less than rows, k plus plus. If this gets satisfied, then I need to print the zeros, that is after number. So again I need to give 0. Okay. So once all these conditions are completely like false, then I need to go to the next line, to go to the second row. To go to the second row, again I need to use system dot out dot println. So system dot out dot println will go to the next line. So these three loops we need to use, and I want to print 5 rows. Okay, I want to print 5 rows. So I have used 3 loops, one loop for rows, another loop for zeros before the number, another loop for zeros after the number. Now let's execute this program and check the output. Okay, let's execute this. See, we got the required pattern as expected. The numbers are in diagonal pattern. Zeros before the number are getting printed because we are using this loop, and zeros are getting printed after the number because we are using another loop, this loop. So this is the logic behind the number pattern. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. Please like, comment and share this video, and kindly subscribe to my channel in order to watch more videos. Thank you so much. Bye. Take care.